Hey, we're here with Petter from Alberta Cross. Thanks so much for taking the time.
Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me, man.
The record's been out for a while, like September, right? But you've been touring it around like crazy.
Yeah. I don't know, it's been out... We released in Europe in September on the internet, I think, and then now it's going to get pushed out in stores in America, I guess, and here.
You're signed to ATO Records. How did... And I know you've played some festivals and you've done some dates with Dave Matthews, and he's sort of still involved with ATO. How did you... hook up with ATO Records?
I think our manager came down to one of our first shows in New York at the Pianos in the Lower East Side, and you know, he just wanted to sign us straight away, really, and he's kind of running ATO with Dave and a few other people, Coran and some other people. So that was it, really. He was into, and we'd like to vibe with him, and you know,
it's a good place to be, right?
That's kind of it, yeah.
Originally from England, from London, but you're now living in New York. Is that the idea?
Well, I was born in Sweden,
right?
And so I grew up there, and then moved to London and lived there forever, and then yeah, now I'm in Brooklyn.
The band is also originally, well, your brother's in the band, so he's originally from.
Well, he was in a band. He started up in a band.
Oh, he's not.
Well, he was kind of helping us out live, you know, and he was with us for a while, and then now he's sort of got a baby now, and he's living in Berlin doing something, touring around Europe.
Cool.
Yeah,
cool. Let's talk a bit about the sound, because it's definitely blues influenced, but to say that you're a blues band wouldn't do you or your sound justice, because it's a lot richer, right? And specifically in production. Can you talk a bit about the production of the record specifically and all the layering that is apparent?
Yeah, I mean, I think we're definitely inspired by rootsy music, by root. I think we're inspired by so much stuff, you know, and like everyone's saying like Brutesy, Blues Band, whatever, but I've listened to so much other stuff, you know, and this record was inspired by quite a few English bands, like My Bloody Valentine and people like that, and like the way, especially like the production, you know, the way, talking about layers, the way they were layering, you know, guitars or keyboards and all that stuff, and so yeah, I produced for us more about getting like a few sound, like just working on this, the piano sound for like a long time, getting like the great sounds and not having too many things on there, but the stuff that's on there, you know, something like grey. more than just like laying on loads of, you know, like the layers you have on there, like, you know.
There's a lot of reverb on the vocals, and there's all kinds of interesting things.
Thing.
Yeah, there's all kinds of interesting elements to the production. How much of it was done off the floor, and then how much of it was overdubbed?
Well, we tried to do a lot of it live. I think almost every song was recorded live, and then, you know, you do like the groundwork live, and then I'll do sort of vocals afterwards, and you know, some other stuff.
Let's talk a bit about your influences. We ask everybody who sits down with us to talk about maybe five records. And those five records probably change almost daily for people. But what are some of those records that, you know, you couldn't live without while you made this record or in general?
Made this record. Well, one is probably like I talk about a lot, but Songs of Faith and Devotion with Depeche Mode. It's kind of a record that's been with me for a while. It's my brother sort of brainwashed me into Depeche Mode when I was a kid. And it's never left me. And that record is like haunting me. So every year I could sort of listen to it for, you know, quite a bit. That was definitely like a big inspiration for this record. Like just sort of the darker years, you know, when they were like more sort of a lot of gospel and soul in there, you know.
Right.
And I love the production of it as well. That's one record. And then, I don't know, man. Other records.
Well, anything, it doesn't...
Boatman's Call with Nick Cave, I guess, a big record.
Right.
I love that record. I couldn't say. I like, I've been listening to lots of like, newer bands. We tour with a band called Dead Confederate from Athens, Georgia.
Right.
I like their record a lot. It's quite a gritty affair. But yeah, I don't know. It's a lot of records that change all the time, so I couldn't really say. I'm into soul music, like James Carr was one of my favourite soul singers. Listen to his music a lot.
Cool.
So yeah, it's a mix of everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
Old Man of Chicago is a departure, though, from the rest of the record in that it's it's stripped down, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you just played it with just an acoustic. Now, was that weird for you guys to do such a heavily produced record and then take the time to do something like Old Man of Chicago, which is just totally stripped down and totally different from the rest of the record?
I don't know. I mean, I think Oh My Chicago, I don't know how stripped down I want this, but Ghost of City Life is definitely, like, the last song on the record is definitely really stripped down.
Right.
But I think...
In terms of, it's not, in terms of, by stripped down, I mean, there doesn't seem to be a lot of production on mm-hmm. it, as opposed to some of the other songs on the record, like even ATX, which is, you know, heavily produced.
Well, yeah, I mean, you have to give people a bit of a breather, and it's not, like I said, I don't think, I don't think the records sound produced, but it's not, like, overproduced.
No, know? No, not at
and,
all.
And
yeah.
I think, but I think, I mean, Ghost City Life and maybe Rise from the Shadows, like, a bit more of a breather. It's just, like, you know, not too many sounds. Just, like, focus on a few.
When you're tracking the record or when you're making the record, is that something that you're cognizant of, like, where things are going to fit? Because Ghost of the City Life, mm-hmm. Is that the back end? And is that on purpose as a good segue out? Or do you just...
Just happened, really.
Just happened?
Yeah, it just happened. But it felt good to leave on that note, you know? Because I was, the Stone is like one of my favorite tracks on the album, for sure.
What's next for you guys? You're touring the record?
Yeah, we tour forever. We're touring with Black Rebel Motorcycle Club now for like 2 weeks. And then we're off touring with Ben Harper for
a month. Seven.
And then we're going on a headline tour, the biggest headline tour yet in America for like about a month and a half.
And then I guess.
And then we're doing festivals everywhere. We're going to Australia and Japan and Europe. A lot of places, really. It's going to be a crazy year.
Good luck, and we'll see you when you're back, man.
Cheers,
thanks,
man.
Cheers.
Thanks, man.